Peace family, welcome to another episode of Underground Railroad Productions, UGR TV. Turtle Gang, been seeing you for quite some time. I have never met somebody who has, you're one of the most adamant brothers I've seen on the scenes when it comes to telling what we call black people that they are indigenous to this country. There's a lot of misconceptions flowing around. I see you, when I was on Facebook, I seen you post a lot. I know you have a bloodline that you share that you can actually prove. You have history that you can actually prove. Tell the people that are totally, I mean totally fucking confused by all the talk going on in the black community about you're African, no you're Asian, no you're the real Indians, no you're this now. Fuck it, we came from everywhere. People like, I don't know what to think anymore. Turtle Gang, just tell the people, clear up some confusion for them, because I know you're real adamant about that.
Okay, first of all, I'd like to say welagun to walken. Peace, manishi to all my indigenous relatives on Turtle Island. Basically, when you deal with indigenous culture, everybody on this planet is a descendant of a tribe. Whether you know it or not, you descend from a tribe. Now, all these tribes have their history. A lot of us have been written out of history, and it's called paper genocide. Laws were passed starting in the 1700s, 1800s, but the final law that was passed was called the Racial Integrity Act, which was passed in 1924. This act changed people of, it took your nationality away from you and reduced you to a racial category. So that would be Negro, colored, things of that nature.
The Racial Integrity Act, championed by state lawmakers and officials like Walter Plecker, challenged their very identity as a people.
When you look back, you're going to find that a lot of your ancestors were documented as being colored. Now, when you understand that the original term for colored represented anyone who was Native American and black. But the point is, black is not a nationality. When they say black, they hide in the nationality.
It wipes away their identity on paper, their ability to describe themselves as Indian was not possible.
But I know change gon' come. Oh, yes it will.
Indians of Monmouth County, New Jersey, were the Lenape. Origins of their tribe still dot the area. The Navasink were a group of Lenape who inhabited the Raritan Bay Shore near Sandy Hook and Mount Mitchell in eastern New Jersey. Archaeologists have been able to trace the Indian population of Monmouth County back 12,000 years. The first recorded European observation New Jersey Lenape Indians was by Giovanni de Verrazzano. He was exploring the New York Harbor, Sandy Hook area in 1524. The explorer Henry Hudson, an English sea captain, first had contact with the Navasink among Native Americans, as recorded in journals from his ship, the Half Moon, in September of 1609.
The 2nd of September, 1609, in the morning. Close weather. The wind at south in the morning. From 12 until 2 of the clock, we steered north-northwest. We saw a great fire, but could not see the land. Then the sun arose, and we steered away north again, and saw the land from the west by north to the northwest, all like broken islands. This is a very good land to fall with, and a pleasant land to see.
These are some of the first recorded impressions of the New Jersey coast. They come from the journal of Robert Jewett, a mate aboard Henry Hudson's ship, the Half Moon.
On September 6, 1609, John Coleman was part of a rowboat expedition of five exploring the harbor when it came under attack by Navasink Lenape. Coleman was struck through the throat by an arrow. It is the first recorded murder in what became New York City. The place where he died was named Coleman's Point, but is now known as Sandy Hook. Coleman was buried at Coney Island.
The Dutch, Swedes, and Finns were the first European settlers in New Jersey.
A new society was taking shape and a new landscape.
In 1664, the Dutch lost New Netherlands.
New Netherland lasted only 40 years, but during this period, the foundations were laid for the New Jersey legacy.
When the English sloop came downriver to the bay, the Dutch accused them of unbecoming anti-government activity. The English gave an evasive and dismissive reply and continued sailing. Next came Hans, arriving with the Lenape chiefs, who told the Dutch that the English had given them rum and wampum as gifts and asked to buy some land. Determined to catch up with the English and prevent them from making a purchase, the Dutch group sailed across the bay to its southern shore near Sandy Hook. The Dutch were accompanied by a Lenape guide who knew the Navasink lands and lived in the Lenape village of Ramazing on the Suing River near today's Tinton Falls. The English also had a Lenape guide with them, another resident of Ramazing. Though living in the same village, the two Lenape were from different factions, one pro-Dutch and one pro-English. The Dutch, already angered by the English scouting for land, had additional reason for fury. The Lenape guiding the English was originally from Long Island in the Gravesend area and had taken part several years ago in killing some Dutch inhabitants of Queens during an Indian uprising. He had fled to the Navasink region, where his militant hatred for the Dutch had won him high status, and he became something of an agent for the English. Favoring the English, he sold them three tracts of land in Monmouth County. The next day, December 12, the Dutch met with Chief Matana, who put his signature mark on two deeds in 1651, and on a Staten Island sale deed with five other Lenape in 1657. In this new negotiation, the Dutch preempted the English by obtaining a promise that Matano and his people would sell the unsold lands of the Navasink to the Dutch for a price not determined. 2 weeks later, on December 26, Matano told the Dutch his sale price for the Navasink lands was 4,000 guilders. The price was so high and so angered the Dutch authorities that they decided to use force to get better terms. They began planning to send a garrison of 30 soldiers to the area, but soon found that because of Dutch military battles with Lenape in the lower Hudson Valley, no troops could be spared for the expedition. This left the path open for a purchase by the English, who then invited the Navasink chief, Papa Mora, for a visit to Long Island in February 1664. Papa Mora now changed his mind and promised to sell land only to the English, not the Dutch.
The first colony established in New Jersey is called Middletown. Middletown sits on the Navasink River. The Navasink is the name of my tribe. It means those closest to the river. You can easily deal with who you truly were when you start decoding the history of the towns and the cities and the boroughs you grew up in. My family in particular, we're documented as one of the oldest three families that was on record as being here when the Europeans established their first colony, which was Middletown, which is on the northern bank of the Navasink River. The southern bank of the That's where I'm from.
Okay, even when I take the census report, or fill out job applications, I put Native American. Because we are from the first limits of the Lenape Indians.
Right.
Okay, so that bloodline runs right through us. Runs right through us. Right. Right. Right.
In contrast to the persistence of the Swedes, the Dutch, and African Americans, the stage was set during this period for the eventual disappearance of the Lenape Indians from the cultural landscape of New Jersey.
The first purchase of land from the Indians on the North American continent took place in the early part of 1665 and was confirmed before Governor Nichols of New York on April 7th and 8th, 1665. This deed was for lands now part of Monmouth County and was recorded in the office of the Secretary of State at Albany, New York. Two other deeds from the Indians for lands nearby were filled, and on April 8, 1665, the governor signed the famous Monmouth Patent, which gave free liberty of conscience without any molestation or disturbance whatsoever in the way of worship. And this Monmouth Patent was recorded in the office of the Recorder of New York, November 8, 1665, 17 years before William Penn made his celebrated treaty at Philadelphia with the Indians. That scene in New York where the Indian sachems pointed to the founders of Monmouth and said in substance, "These men have paid us for our land. Give them a patent," has for better and prior right to be commemorated than does Penn's treaty made 17 years afterward, the praises of which have been sung throughout the world in both paintings and writings. The significance of the Navasink Lenape has not been recognized to this day, and the descendants of the Navasinks have been forced to pay a heavy price.
It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will.